Shalom to everybody. Today, with God's help, we will have a conversation with some young guys, right? Different topics. All right, what would you like to talk about?
Is this my tea? Yeah. Is it my? Yeah. Oh, thanks. What do I want to talk about? I don't know, we've been learning the sugya of what's going on in the world for a while, and we just like kind of talked about it before the camera came on, but we've been learning the sugya of what's going on in the world with Shiabud Malchus, right? And the Gemara in Sanhedrin and Tzadi Tes Amar Aleph, right? And it's and Pliga the Shmuel, right? Amar Shmuel Ein bein olam haze limus mashiach ela shiabud malchus bilvad. Aber in Pesachim daf samich ches amud aleph. The Gemara brings the same machlokas Rabbi Yochanan and Shmuel. Rabbi Yochanan Kohen Neviim kulam lo nisnabu el imos mashiach. They didn't give all of the nevuah is talking about imos mashiach. And in olam haba ayin lo ra, so we have no hasaga.
Yeah.
But then it says Pliga de Shmuel, the Amar Shmuel, Ein bein olam haze liyamos mashiach ela shiabud galiyos bilvad. So I guess the first question, and we've been talking about the sugya. From the sugya, we like started realizing what was going on and all the perfidy that's going on in worldwide politics and how like fake it is. But I've always had this question, which is, and I've been thinking like, what's the difference between shiabud malchus and shiabud galiyos? If you have like a mahalach, I don't know,
Well, it can be the same thing, if it's the same...
You think there's a difference, or you think it's like...
Both of them say Rav Shmuel, so...
It's just Shmuel.
We are still really in Galut. We are in exile. It, for sure, in our mind control.
Yeah.
In the mind control that's going on today in the world.
Yeah.
We are all... Not only Jew.
But we're thinking that like it's like there's the mind control that's going on in the world, and they think like propaganda was invented by the Nazis. But actually, if you look at the Indian of the Heir of Rav, it says Vayitu es Lev Yisrael, right? That the Indian of the Heir of Rav was this propaganda, was like trying to get, and then the Eden fell for it, and they, or the Israelites fell for it, and they were like, oh, like we gotta go back to Mitzrayim, we gotta get those watermelons, yo, and those squashes and those things. That was the same thing that's going on now, and like they're trying to control minds, and they're trying to control lives, you know, trying to control hearts and control minds, and we're like, yo, like, oh, this is like a new thing. Like, no, this wasn't a new thing, and it also wasn't a new thing by the Nazis. This has been going on since ever, you know.
Yeah. So it's really nothing new, and we are still in exile.
We're in Esav.
In exile.
Oh, in exile.
Yeah, we are still in exile. Even this Medinat Israel, when we think about who really organized this,
yeah,
who was behind it.
Yeah. We've been looking into that sugya. You know, like, I went to the army, I was like a big Zionist, and like love Medinat Israel, and like...
All right, we can love Medinat Israel. We can love...
But... Like what's going on? Because a lot of the conspiracy theorists
who really lead. Well,
yeah, the Israel. See, it seems like Israel is just playing along with this whole pandemic that COVID-1984. Yeah. That the whole world is like shtelling a vec, and Medina Israel has no problem playing with it, like playing along, you know. Yeah. And like so, like what's going on? Like who is in charge in Israel? I mean, I see like from the book.
It's not Kahol Lavan, it's not nobody there.
It's not nobody we heard of?
It's all puppets, you know.
So, yeah. What's very interesting is that we've been learning the sugya and talking about this stuff, and we've been talking about it from an American perspective, because, hooray, we're Americans, and we know American politics best. So we've been talking about American politics and world politics, and, you know, we've spoken about the Crown, and we've spoken about the Vatican, and a lot of people like in the world that like deal with this stuff, also a lot of them like think that like they put like Israel and Zionism in like such a high up place in like world events. And I just thought that was strange, like, because like, what, is Israel not just like another country that they're controlling? So, or is Israel, is there like something like different?
Yeah, so far all this control was hiding, you know, so we can feel that really we have here something independent and it's just us. But right now they reveal their face. It's not anymore hiding a control, you know.
Reveal. No, this is it. Like
they reveal their face slowly. They don't want to do it in once, so they have excuse to. But they reveal their ugly face, you know.
They reveal their face while telling us to cover up our faces.
Our face, exactly.
Wow.
Yeah. Those masks.
You know, they are.
It's very interesting.
There are
wow.
five degrees of worship the devil.
Five what?
Degree of worship the devil.
Of worship.
You can parallel it to Yudke Vavke.
And Kutso Shoyod?
Kutso Shoyod, the crown is a
corona.
Yeah,
Hamesh. Yeah,
Kutso Shoyod. The corona is a crown.
Dude, we learned this. Also, we got to that through the Sugya. To answer the steer of the Rambam, like, is passing like Rabbi Yochanan or like Shmuel. Rabbi Yochanan or Shmuel is like a steer in the Rambam. The Ben Aryeh says, no, it's not Kasha, because this is talking about Mashiach ben Yosef, this is talking about Mashiach ben David. As I state, the Ben Aryeh, and he quotes the game. So we actually saw some Safra in our time.
It's right there, it's the same thing.
Where? Ah, Safra, it's near, it's a Gavaldi.
I'm scanning for upside down books.
So we saw some Safra, whatever. I ended up giving maybe a different terrace, because the Rambam doesn't mention Mashiach ben Yosef or Mashiach ben David. But he does mention Kodim Shiyavo Eliyahu Mashiach Me'at Yavo Eliyahu. So like according to that, we're thinking like, yo, maybe Eliyahu is Mashiach ben Yosef. Aber, the Ramban, when he's talking about this idea, he seems to imply that Eliyahu is Mashiach ben David. He says Mashiach ben Yosef and Eliyahu. So it's another thing.
There are four concepts of Eliyahu, there are four concepts of Mashiach ben David, of Mashiach, right? Four Harashim in the book of Zechariah. There are four Harashim, it means people that working with iron, but it means two.
The four craftsmen.
It means smart people. Harash, Choresh, Machshavot.
Right.
There are four leaders.
Harisha, yeah. We're learning Shemitah. So we just talked about Harisha today.
Parallel to the four corners of the world, and it goes to the four riders in the book of Revelation of Apocalypse.
Yeah.
That related to the four corners of the world, because it's the face of the lion. The lion represents the rights. They came and then appears the riding on the white horse after...
Right.
The bull in the left, the riding on the red horse like fire.
I haven't learned this other New Testament.
So you don't know.
I don't know. I'm not holding in it.
This all what I teach. What I do rectification of it of what's going on there in all Christianity in the book of in the New Testament.
Yeah.
This my.
No, it's very chashuv.
Mumchayut.
In the New Testament.
Which version?
This what I teach. I teach especially goyim.
Where?
In the internet. For YouTube, for Facebook.
Oh, nice.
This is what I'm doing.
Which version of the
I do rectification of Christianity for many years.
You do what about Christianity?
Rectification of Christianity.
Rectification. Yeah, we heard about and we saw the Moshe David Valley that says Beferish. You know?
Yeah, he says a little bit good thing about Jesus.
Yeah.
I think that we have to bring him back to Am Yisrael, and he's referred to one of the four Harashim.
He's referred to as one of the Harashim?
Yeah, he's riding on the green horse.
On the green horse,
the last one. That refers to the eagle. He's riding on the Susirakrak, Yarok, Green. He's calling him Jesus, Yeshua.
Yarok.
Yeah, I agree. I'm just curious, like what the signals.
Yeah, we see us.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. I'm just curious.
You don't want to be there?
No, I'm good. Chill.
Alright.
Yeah, I just wasn't sure.
Alright, so there are four concepts of Mashiach, and they are really all united in somehow. And the one that we call Jesus Yeshua, it means the first coming of Jesus. It's not the whole concept of Mashiach. It's not the whole concept of Jesus himself, what was revealed in his first coming. When we say Yeshua, we refer to the naked one. You know what? You know
a little bit about this? This is what I'm trying to get set up, yo.
Yeshua, we call a room.
He's naked.
Exactly.
Naked. Now, if he's naked, it is written, Kitira room, Vachisito. If you see a naked one, you have to hide him. You cannot talk about him. Vachisito. It means you cover him. It means you cannot talk about, you cover him. But from the other side, you give him dress. Now, why is naked? Why is naked? Because a part of the soul that refers to the Mashiach himself, it's mean. You know, the soul has five levels. Nefesh, Ruach, Neshama, Chaya, Yechida. So, David is a general Nefesh of Am Yisrael, Eliyahu HaNevi is the general Ruach. The general Mashiach is Yechida. It means the Mashiach is the general Yechida of Am Yisrael. And the Yechida didn't take part of the sin of Adam HaRishon. When the first man go to sin, the Yechida ran away.
Where do you know this from?
Well, it's a thing in Kabbalah, in Hasidut, it's famous. It means the first man was created only with the four levels of the soul, until the Chaya. והיפר בפיו נשמת חיים, והיא אדם לנפש חיה. הוא אוהב נפש, הוא אוהב חיה, הוא אוהב נשמה, and about נפש חיה, אונקלוס ראה את רוח ממללה.
ממללה, and speech.
So you have the רוח too. really, the נשמת חיים refer to the three level of the soul that are what you call the נפש, that refer to the liver, the Ruach that refer to the emotion, to the heart, and the Neshama that refer to the intellect, Nishmat Shakai Tevinem.
What?
Nishmat Shaddai Tevinem.
Right.
It's mean, Tevinem, right. Understanding have to do with Neshama.
Yeah,
so this is the Orot Pnimim, the...
And what's Chaya?
Chaya
is consciousness.
It's Makif Karov. It's a close surround light.
So I don't know what that even means. Like,
you know, surround light, it's mean it's not.
The way that I learned it is that, sorry, I just like, we're going, we're saying like it's feelings and emotions, sorry, it's feelings and emotions and thought.
Chaya, it's like Olam Atzilut. It's mean.
Chaya is, yeah, it's Olam Atzilut.
It contains everything, it's everywhere. It's consciousness. Not here.
But wait. We don't have like a Seder here. Because we're saying that Nefesh is feelings and Ruach is
nefesh,
emotions.
No, Nefesh is the instinct feeling.
Instinct feeling, yeah.
It's more a feeling that going with action, like self-confidence, like tmimut, naivety, like emet is realization, you know.
Okay. That's nefesh, and then ruach we're saying is emotion.
Ruach
which
is
I
emotion.
Hear.
It's
I hear
love
that.
And fear.
Yeah, it says by in Parshas Beshalach, it says mikotzer ruach, avodah kasha, right? And then you have neshama, and neshama intellect totally shtem. I believe that chaya is consciousness, right? Which is higher than intellect. It's not just our intellect, but it's our, like...
Well, you can't say Zeus,
right?
But
and then,
if you parallel the different part of the soul to the world,
yeah,
the nefesh refer to Olam HaAsiyah.
Nice.
The spirituality
Olam
of Olam HaAsiyah.
Right.
It is something below the nefesh, what is the physical body. Who represents the physical body is the rider on the white horse. This is what we have in this picture here. This is the white horse.
Oh, I wasn't sure what that was.
The donkey riding on the white horse.
V'erkivuhu chamor.
V'erkivu al asus.
Al asus,
right.
They put
him on top of the horse, but the gimeti of the v'erkivu equal chamor.
Wow.
Equal donkey.
Mashiach is going to come.
So this is the secret of the white donkey of Mashiach, because really the donkey is black. The horse is white, and together they forming the white donkey. The white from
this.
The donkey. It's like Maaseh Merkava of two personality. One that represents the evil in a good way. It means the body, the Yetzer Hara, the firstborn Esav, represents the body, this world. The other one basically represents the good guy, Yaakov, the soul, Olam Haba, this is a white horse. Now, in Purim equal Chamor Lavan, white donkey, you will think that the evil will support the good, but in Purim is everything in reverse.
Yeah.
You see the bad guy riding on the good guy. Right? This is Purim.
So
together you call them Chamor Lavan, what is like Chomer Ulvenim.
Chomer Ulvenim.
Chamor Lavan.
Like
how much
it.
Equal Chomer plus Levenim?
What?
How much equal in Gimetia Chomer plus Levenim? How much equal?
Oh, how much equal?
Chomer Levenim.
What is
like Chamor
Lavan?
Equal,
I don't know. 248
equal 3.
Although that's 248, and then the levanim, the vinim, I have to add it. We have 248, and we have
178. 132.
What?
132.
Right.
132.
232 and
248. 280.
Is
380.
380, what is Egypt?
Mm.
What is Sus plus Hamor?
Mm.
אשר פסח המורים שרם וזרמת סוסים זרמתם. It's a פסוק מפורש in יחזקאל, that the Egyptian have a blood
of
horse
and
have a flesh of donkey. Right? So
yeah.
This is like the two guy. This is what Jesus calls the body and the blood of Mashiach.
By the Eucharist.
He will give the bread, he said, this is my body, he will give the wine, he will say, this is my blood.
I hear. Listen, I like Gemara, you know, I come from a base Medrash, I come from the Mir, I come from Gula Show. Like, Gematria is cool and everything, and it's pretty amazing.
Gematria is like a
Gzera. It's parot lechuchma.
No, it's not. No, no. תקופות וגימטיות.
Okay.
It's mean it's astrology calculation is parperot לחוכמה.
גם וגם
no.
גימטיות.
No,
is
no.
Is it בסדר? Is it interesting?
No, no.
But like...
Rabbi Ginsburg זה גימטיות is גופי הלכות. Rabbi Ginsburg is today is גדול הדור, for my opinion. He wrote over 200
okay.
books. And he say, they refer to חישובי אסטרונומיה, what is parperot. But just gematriot of word, Rabbi Ginsburg he said in with his mouth is gufei halachot. Rabbi Ginsburg do a lot of gematria. No. Gematria is a gzera shava. If gzera shava, it's
meant. Gematria is not gzera shava. Gzera shava is
no.
mentioned in the Medrash.
Rabbi Ginsburg say.
Okay.
What is gzera shava?
Gzera shava is mentioned.
Gzera shava, it's mean.
It's mentioned in the Medrash.
I don't care.
Gematria is not.
I
do.
No. Gzera shava, it means it can be anything. It is written here something similar to something else that is written here.
She's saying
can be anything
Gematria
similar.
Gzera shava. Okay. That's
anything
she's
similar.
Saying,
it is דברי תורה עניים במקום אחד, עשירים במקום אחר. It's meaning it is something else because he use the same, something similar to here, I can make a connection between this and this. It seems that is no connection.
Amazing.
Because it's two different things, right?
Amazing.
Nachash equal Mashiach in Gematria. It seems to be, what? It's opposite, it's completely something else. No, it's the same thing. It's why the snake of Moses can heal you from the bad snake, so it can be a good snake too.
I'm thinking like, if you're going to say that that's pshat, that gematria is pshat
it's not
in the
pshat.
Measures.
No,
it's pshat in the measures, and the measures says gzeira shava, that what
no.
It's talking about is also gematria?
No, in the Zohar it says that gematria is gay mituraya, gay.
Gay.
It means it's a
valley
between two mountains. Gay.
Gay.
Turaya is mountain.
Turaya. Right.
It's gematria.
Like yeah.
And in the future, kol gay yinase. It means the gematria will be more important of the mountain. What is it? The mountain is like the letter. And the gematria is like the gay. But in the future, kol gay yinase. Something that is not important in this world, it is writing even ma'asu abonim. You have another gematria. Even ma'asu abonim. Right? It's a Freemasonry.
Freemasonry.
Even ma'asu abonim equal in gematria gematria. 273. So you can talk about many, many stones. You know, the Christian will say that it's referred to Jesus. Everybody will say that it's referred to something else. But the gematria tell me Gzera Shava from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Now, if I understand the Gzera Shava, it's another problem. There can be many gematria that nobody understands.
You're saying that Gzera Shava in the Medrash, right, which is Rabbi Shmuel.
I don't care. I'm not going to talk about what they say and what they don't say. Right? I talk about what I learned from my rabbi, that is the biggest in the world.
He's not the biggest, Rav Asher is the biggest, but whatever.
No, well, for my opinion,
okay,
he's the
fine.
Biggest.
That's fair.
But I am his
so
disciple.
We have two different schools.
And he's a mathematician, he do a lot of gematriot. And all my knowledge about Mashiach, I am Mumche about Mashiach, Rabbi Ginzburg said about me 30 years ago that I am Gdolei Olam about
Mashiach.
35 years ago he said it.
Okay.
Right? So all what I know about Mashiach, it's not what a Rambam say, it's not what it is written in the Talmud, it's not what it is say Rabbi Nachman Mibresev or whatever, everybody is great, everybody say very true and good thing.
Okay.
But what I know is thanks 99% of what I know is mean 1% is from the Rambam and from everybody, but 99% is from Gematria. Like I tell you now, the Jesus.
Like I tell you that the white
donkey of Mashiach is not a donkey, is not a white donkey, is a black donkey, and I can prove you why it's a black donkey, and it's a horse and a donkey together, because Homer Levanim equals Sus plus Hamor. Equal Egypt, and it is written Psach Hamorim Saram, Vezemat Susim Zrematam.
Okay. So
for me, Gematria
is still parporos.
So and I have another another hint. They put the donkey on top of the horse, and Purim equal Chamor Lavan. So we talk. This is the main picture
very,
of Purim that they put. This is
brilliant.
The way
it's brilliant.
The redemption starts that they put Mordechai on the horse. All right. So Mordechai become a donkey. How I know that is black? You know how much equal black? Shachor. Equal 514. What is ben pered ben sus? Son of mule.
Son of
that is son
right.
of. So we're talking about three generations. Three generations. You know how to call, are you calling the in Hasidut three generations?
I'm saying I still hold that Gemara is parparot. Like I have a Gemara. You're saying that you learn that Gemara differently. You're saying tkufot.
It can be parparot for you. For me, I learn from it.
It's amazing.
With
I'm not
capability.
Saying exactly. Everyone has
for
their
you,
own
it's
path.
A joke. For me,
no, it's not a joke. Parparot doesn't mean a joke.
Parparot is meant for the desert. The desert can be
desert.
The Afikoman refers to Mashiach. Can be something very, very important. The desert.
I wasn't saying it wasn't important. I was just saying that, like, I'm just getting.
Is 277.
The Gematria of Gematria and the Gematria of Masu Abonim is equal?
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Gematria is 273. And Kilo Davareku Mikem, Rashira Tifreku Mikemu equal Gematriot. Kilo Davareku Mikem equal Gematria Gematriot. Same Gematria, right? Is nothing in the Torah that is not important. This is what is said, right? And in the Zohar, it means when we go to the learning of the sod, Gematria, and when we talk about the future, about the coming of Mashiach, it's like to say that science is not important. Gematria, this is what makes everything we teach science. Science, because about each number you can learn all your life. Each number. Why we have Tariag Mitzvot? You have any idea?
Yeah, it's a Gemara.
Why?
The Gemara says Torah.
Why?
Torah Tzivah Lanu Moshe Morashak Kiles
Yaakov. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Torah
but why?
611, and
why?
Then you have two. I just know Gemaras. But
nobody teaches you why.
Is
it different?
No, it's not true. It's a Gemara says. And then you have the two that Moshe showed me, Piatma, Torah 611.
We learn the wisdom of God. The wisdom is mean I want to understand why. Torah is a wisdom. It's the wisdom of God. Why he decides that will be 613 commandments?
Why did he?
Why Mashiach equal 358? Why not 359? It will be Satan, 359, even better. Why not? Why? Why this number? Each number you can learn all your life in mathematics. Have different quality. It can be a prime number, it can be not a prime number, it can be a triangle, it can be a square, it can be a pyramid, it can be many things. So in the moment you're drawing a picture, it's a story. A picture, you know, a triangle, it's a picture, it's a story. It can be a roof of a house. You know, if you do Yud Ke Vav Ke, Yud, is 10, is a triangle of 4. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4.
Okay.
And HaVavK is 16, is a square of 4. So you have a house. This is YudKeVavK. So it tells you something. It's a picture. Has a form. It tells you a story. Sipur, Mispar, the same letter in Hebrew. Why the same letter? Because each mispar tell you a sipur. Right? And you know,
how long never of the sefer.
Everything
sefer,
that it is written in Gemara, in Talmud,
right,
hiding beside secret. They have some Ruach HaKodesh so they tell you it's so. But if I want to understand in a way that really it's very precise, and it's connect all the Torah to the science, to the true science, not the science of the
Illuminati. Not the science of the Illuminati.
All right,
right, the real science, not the mainstream.
In the moment.
And you're saying the science is
we want
numbers?
To make we want to make the root of all science is mathematics. This is like
okay.
The Malkata Madaim, the queen of all science.
And this is and that's all it's the best science,
of math, all
science math. That's all Esav.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
All Esav.
It's why we have to bring Esav back to Am Israel. It's one of the reasons.
Wait,
and
no,
it's
no,
what
wait.
I represent. I represent Esav.
You represent Esav.
All right.
Science.
I talk in the name. Everything I say in the name of Esav, because I am a chozer b'tshuva, so I am a chazir. Chazir came from the word chozer. All right.
Rego, why did you say that science and math was Esav?
Esav say yes, Lirav, have to do with quantity, with detail. You know, Esav is a big mekubal. Oh, I know why
yeah,
your name is Yaakov.
But Yosef was dealing with like, all of this stuff.
Is Doresh in the name, you know? Oh, now I know why your name is Yaakov. Because
right,
you're
in the name.
Oh, I see.
Kekven is Ev.
So you see that he's looked in the detail. How
in
I know
the what?
Detail.
Oh, the
details.
Detail, yeah.
Yaakov, he look about the details? No, he don't. He take many stone. Our sages said, one opinion 3 stone, another opinion 7 stone.
To say that
other
also,
opinion 12 stone. So you have the
right.
The Aleph Bet that is 3 emesh, 7 beget kafrat, 7 double, and 12 simple letter. So he took the 22 letter. And when he wake up, it's only one stone.
Right.
Why? Because for him, all the stone is the same.
Because Kol Echad said, I want to decide
for him, for Yaakov.
And also, Yisachar was like Yodei Bina. They were like astronomers and stuff. How could you say that all science comes from Esav? That all science
but Yisachar, how you know that?
No, it's more like a representation. Not that.
Yes.
Okay.
First of all, Esav born Jew, so he has a rectification as a Jew, and Yitzchak that love Esav is not as stupid.
Of course not.
All right.
So,
Akadosh Baruch Hu that decides that Esav will be the firstborn and not Yaakov is not stupid too. All right. So Esav is, if we talk about the good in Esav, is million times higher of Yaakov. Because he's a firstborn, all right.
And
so
this I've heard from.
So, Esav have his quality, okay. And in the future, it is written that Esav will come back to Am Israel. Now we are in an exile of Esav for 2,000
right,
years.
The Jesuits.
Edom.
Edom. Yeah.
Malchut Edom.
Yeah, the Vatican.
Edom is Esav. Refer to Esav.
Of course.
All right, so...
The vast.
So, if we have, you know, it is written that Yaakov saw the angel in his dream going up and going down. He saw the Malchuyot, the angel of Ashur going up, after going down, after the angel of Bavel,
right.
After the angel of Yavan going up, and after he saw the angel of Esav going up, he's not going down. Esav is not going down because
right.
He's Jew. You have to bring him back to Am Israel. He's not going down. You are not going to win him. To win against
right.
Him.
That's
because
it.
He's more strong. Okay?
Esav...
So, and if we have 2,000 years in exile of Edom, it means we have a work to do this that we didn't did it for some reason. We didn't did it.
Right, we haven't done it yet. We're still in...
It's why we are still in exile.
Yeah.
I did it. All this book is the Torah of Esav. But...
Is the Torah of Esav?
All the book, of course. Who adapt Jesus? Edom. Rome. Right?
Right.
Adapt as Mashiach because
yeah.
he's too physical.
But why do you say it's the
so
Torah of
Esav? So he adapt Mashiach that is too spiritual.
But why do you say it's the Torah of Esav? Why do you say it's Torah?
All the book is based on the word chen. All the book is the Ark of Noah. Ark in Hebrew it means word.
It means what?
Word.
What means word?
Ark.
At?
Ark. Tevat.
Oh, Teva.
Teva.
Right.
Tevot
okay.
Is meaning.
I mean, yeah, I got it.
A free Tevot from six, free stone from 6 Tevot. Like it is written. All right, Tevot is...
Yeah.
Is words. Tevat Noach, it means it's the word of Noach, what is Chen. All this book is based on the word Chen, and the name of the book is Yimach Shmo, Yimach equal Chen. Okay? After we go maybe more to detail what mean these 3 letters, because all the secret of Mashiach hiding in these 3 letters. And you have here the letter of Mashiach. Even
yeah,
when
yeah,
you,
yeah, yeah, we saw that.
All right, so, and what it is written in the Torah about Chen? Sheker Chen. Chen is a lie. Right, so this is the Torah of the lie.
Yeah, but Yodei Chen.
Yeah.
Nachon,
but what is Chochma Nistara? Is the Chochma of the lie. Did you know this?
I still don't know that.
How I know that Chen has to do with lie? It is written, Sheker Achen. It's a Pasuk Meforash. And Hevel Ayofi, how I know that it has to do with Emet?
With Emet?
Yeah, Hevel Ayofi. Now we are in Parashat Lech Lecha. Equal Yofi. 100, right?
Well,
Lech Lecha.
Yes, Lech Lecha. Lech Lecha, I got it, I did it in my head. It's 30, it's 50 and 50.
Lech Lecha.
I got it, yeah, it's not hard.
Well,
but what are you saying? You're saying, what else
is called Yofi? Now, in the parasha next week, Vayera.
Bro, Yofi is filled with Vav.
No, Yofi in the Torah never splits writing in the Vav. Always like this. Always.
It's possible.
Never writing Yofi with a vibe.
Never mention Yofi.
Never. Yofi, it's only with no vibe. You have to write it. Okay?
Yofi.
It's not a newspaper. I talk about Torah. Right? In newspaper, you will write always Yofi with a
vibe.
In the Torah, it will be written with no vibe. Right? It's 100.
Yippee.
Now, next week, we are in the Parashat Vayera. If you do the gematria with order number gematria,
with all the number,
it means the order of the letter.
It's 217.
No, order number. Resh is a 20.
Maze order number.
Resh is a 20 letter.
Kilo is a mispar.
Yeah, order.
איך זה נקרא? איזה גמרא זה?
מספר סידורי.
מספר סידורי.
Order number. It's not used in Chazal still.
Yeah, it's not used in Chazal. I've never seen it.
Still, we are allowed to use it.
Right. Allowed, yeah, you could use everything.
I don't have to ask nobody.
Yeah, for sure, I said, that's exactly what I said, you could use everything. Everyone has their own path. This is just a path that I've never seen before, I'm Lamdish, yo.
Alright.
I like Gemara. I like,
it's,
see, like, what
it's the
think.
Order of the letter in the alphabet. The order, it's something that exists in reality.
Where's the first place?
The Resh is the 20 order in the alphabet.
איפה,
so
איפה פעם ראשונה שמשתמשים בגמטריה הזו?
רבי גינזבורג is the first one.
רבי גינזבורג made that up? Not made that up, but like he was מחדש.
He מחדש it. I don't know if somebody else used it before him. Or how much he called Vayera in מספר סידורי?
I don't know, 6, 1, 10 and
20? 37. How much he called Yofi in מספר סידורי?
10,
20, 13. This is 17 letters, so 37, Yofi 2. Alright, so, now, what it is written in Parashat Vayera, Vavram ben Me'at Shanim,
Beledot
Yitzchak, no, Me'at, is a letter of Emet. True. But it's 100, it means it refers to Yofi. Okay, so you can see that Yofi is a met. In another way, you can see that Yofi is a met. Yofi is 10 square. Yud peamim Yud. Yofi.
Yeah.
It's even acronym. It's not only in Gimetia, Andre, the acronym of Yud peamim Yud.
It's ma.
Acronym.
Acronym, like the first letters?
Acronym.
Yeah. Acronym. Acronym.
Oh, acronym.
Okay.
Acronym. So if I take...
I thought you were saying acronym.
Acronym. If I...
Acronym.
I'm sorry for my English.
Oh, it's totally
if
chill.
If I take a square of 10, right? Square of 10.
Uh-huh.
Right? Whatever.
Whatever, yeah.
How many...
You'd have 100.
I will have 100 square, right?
100 square, yeah, nice. And
how many points I will have?
How many points?
Point.
Like in between?
Yeah, all the point. All the kodkodim, how many?
Oh, all the kodkodim?
121.
Okay, 11 square. I have to think about that. So, how do you have 20?
11 square, because there are 11
11 squares, nice. Yeah.
How
okay.
How many tzla'ot I will have?
Wait, I don't know.
220.
220?
How much equal together?
Wait, 220?
Emmet. So you see that Yofi, Hevel HaYofi, he referred to Hevel and he referred to Emmet. Hevel is a good guy. So Sheker HaChen referred to Cain. Obvious. Okay? It's the Torah of Cain. So you have Cain, you have Hevel. You have Chen, you have Yofi. It's even the same Gimetia, Hevel HaYofi, right? We saw that Yofi equal Hevel.
Yeah, we saw.
And this is Sheker, and this is Chen. In what age was Noah when he got to the ark? How much old he was?
600
equals Sheker. So you see that Noach Chen in the same letter refer to lie. Now, the last verse in the book of Bereshit, Noach Matza Chen b'nei Hashem, it means this refer to the goal of all creation. The last verse in the parasha of Bereshit.
Yeah.
What it mean Noach Matza Chen?
Noach Matza Chen.
Noach is like Anacha. Axioma.
Axiom.
Anacha.
Yeah.
Is nach. Is rest.
Nach, yeah, nach
is rach. This is why, this is the reality. This is true, this is lie. Right? Now, the Torah tells you, the goal of creation, you have to be able to reverse any anacha. To reverse.
I saw that in your book.
You think that the good will win in the end of the day? Maybe the evil have to win.
Do I think that good will win?
Maybe according to Torah, the evil will win. Mm-hmm. What it is written in the Torah? Let's see what.
Uyeshuvcha
akev. In the rosh, the Adam will win the snake. The snake is a bad guy, right? In the beginning, in the rosh, we will kill the snake. But in the il, it's in the ikveta de meshicha, in the end.
Yeah,
where the snake will bite you.
We're the dust. We're the dust under the feet. They say the last the generation before Mashiach is like the dust under the feet.
Right. Well, I mean,
it starts at the head and ends.
Yeah.
With the lotus.
Ik visit the Mashiach chutzpas yiski.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. This can be a good thing too. Chutzpah is good.
Right. Yeah, chutzpah is good, and also pnei adork and pnei chalev also geshmak. Also zak
the snake wins, but it's a good thing.
Of course.
You can look at anything positively or negatively. It's all about giving a positive.
If the Torah, the Torah is the tree of knowledge, good and evil. If the tree of knowledge, good and evil is connected to the tree of life, all the sin was that they separate the two trees. This is what it is written in the Zohar.
Yeah.
If the tree of knowledge, because it is written that God says, because it's a gun, you can eat from all the tree of the garden. So, including the tree of knowledge, good and evil. But if you eat only the tree of good and evil, you will die. Because if you separate the knowledge from life,
right,
in the moment, you have a knowledge that we have to do 613 commandment, but you don't have the life, the reason. Why? You don't have the why. You connect the knowledge from the tree of knowledge, from the tree of life. If I learn about Africa, but I was not there, I just have a map, this is dead knowledge. This knowledge separate me from a true knowledge, a true unity, because knowledge is unity. With what I learned. V'adam yada et chava. Ladat, it means to be litchabar. If I'm mechubar only to the outside of the knowledge, not to the inside, to the soul of the knowledge, I'm going to die. Because I separate myself from God, from the soul of everything. So this is, if now in Torah are not, all the Torah is holy, all the Torah is good things, there are not curses in the Torah if it is connected to that, to the tree of life. If it is not connected to the tree of life, they are full of curses. There are snakes, there are devils, there are bad things. Yimar Shemo, it's a curse, maybe it's a blessing.
What does this stand for, Yimar Shemo?
This is the way we curse Jesus. Jesus cursed, he did the same thing to the fig tree, you know the story?
Cursing the fig tree.
The fig tree?
You never read the New Testament.
I'm still trying to work my way through Shas and
Paiskin. There's like a few hundred thousand different versions of it, right. So I was like, I don't know where.
Let's see what it is written there.
I have learned the New Testament. I have seen things, like I'm not like opposed to it. I think it's very interesting. I'm curious though, why you put the Chupchik?
Because it's acronym of three words that all the secrets of Mashiach are based on these three words.
So what
Yitzhak, Mashiach, Chen.
Yitzhak, Mashiach, Chen?
These are three words that was revealed to Abba Shem Tov for Mashiach, and he was not allowed to reveal them all his life. You know the Igeret that he wrote to his Giso?
Gershon
Kitov, yeah, he wrote Igeret. He said, I have Aliyat Neshama, I left my body and I get high,
yeah,
in like I never was before, yeah. And I arrived to the nest of the bird, Ken Tzipor, I arrived to the Echal of Mashiach, and I saw Mashiach, you're right, he talked to Mashiach, and he asked Mashiach, Matai Katima, when you will come. So he say, "Him lichshafutzu manotech achutzah." It's a verse in Mishle.
What?
He say him a verse in Mishle.
I
will come when yafutzu ma'ay notecha achutzah.
You wrote yatzufu.
Yafutzu.
Yatzufu, I could have
that. This kind of mistake I do all the time.
Yeah, dyslexia.
I have some of yafutzu.
Yafutsu ma'inotecha
chutzah.
So you're saying the Baal Shem Tov went...
What are the acronym?
Yamach.
Yamach. Alright, so what did you tell you there?
That's interesting. Rega, you say that Baal Shem Tov went to go talk to Mashiach, right? We know that there's Mashiach, the Kol Dor V'Dor, there could be, right? Zok the Gemara.
It is somebody that can receive the soul of Mashiach,
right, who,
every door.
Every door. We know this
but the Mashiach is always in the Ken Tzipor. It don't go here.
No, see, Mashiach in every generation is the biggest Gosh Baruch Hu lasos Cheskiyahu Mashiach the San Cheriv Gog Umagog. Elama Delo Amar Shira. Right? Right? So what I'm saying is that in every generation, there are people that could be...
Who was ill from his sickness, from the Shechin, Chizkiyahu?
Chizkiyahu.
How was he ill?
Why was he ill? Because he didn't want to go to Yishayahu.
But what was the thing that healed him?
Oh, that how he was healed? Oh, because
With the Dvelet Te'anim, with the fig tree. This was the healing of Mashiach. Now, what kind of Mashiach is Chizkiyahu? It is written in Kitve Arizal. Is Mashiach ben David or Mashiach ben Yosef? No, he's written, he wrote Arizal that Chizkiyahu is Mashiach ben Yosef.
Well, the Rav Kook says that he was Mashiach ben David.
Arizal says that he's Mashiach ben Yosef.
You're telling me that Rav Kook is Cholik on the Farish Arizal?
It can be.
Maybe, that would be very interesting. Can I see? Because Rav Kook says it's ben David.
I receive. Rabbi Gilgur say that according to Arizal, Chizkiyahu referred to Mashiach ben Yosef.
But do you have a raya? Raya? Is there a raya?
No, I don't know.
Shemata, it's me, Rav Gilgur. I'll show you, Rav Kook. Karate at the Hesped, at the Masped in Yerushalayim? If Rav Kook medaber al inyan Mashiach? You saw Rav Kook's
piece? I'm not a mumche with Rav Kook. You talk about the Zecharia that he talk about.
He's not a mumche. He calls exactly the
thing. Yeah.
Yeah. So, no, he talks about in Zecharia. He talks about a Yonas HaMen Uziel in Zecharia. They has been like Achav and like Yeravim. And he says, Achven Yeravam were Ben Yosef, you didn't like Herzl. But he says, Cheskia was Mashiach Ben David.
Well, it's all relative, because Cheskia, if you talk about Cheskia relative to Achav, so this belongs to the tree of Judah, so he's Mashar, he's a descendant of David, so he's Mashar Ben David.
And
Ishkai also and Achav belongs to the nation of Etz Yosef, of the 10 tribes, so it belongs to Mashar Ben Yosef. So when it's all relative.
Well, yeah,
it's all. You can say that if he's a descendant of David, so it's for sure Mashar Ben
David. I'm not. I'm saying
still,
because
of his
it is a.
Of course,
it depends what you talk about, right? If you talk about Chizkiyahu compared to Achav, so of course Chizkiyahu is Mashar Ben David.
Well, I'm not comparing him to Achav.
But
I'm not comparing him to Achav. I'm saying that Rav Kook said if he's Be'etzem Mashiach Ben David. And yeah, it's a good source, it's a good raya that yeah, and also he's from.
All right, for me, Yehuda. For me, nothing is not raya. All right.
Nothing is what?
I'm not came to tell you I'm right because he says so.
Yeah, we're just trying to figure it out.
Yeah, no,
I want to see that result.
But I don't know where it is because I'm not Kidvar is good enough.
Could you ask
but I am sure that Rabbi Ginsburg is not wrong about it.
Well, I mean,
because he knows by heart all the Kabbalah of Rishonim, Achronim, of whatever. He learned 26 books of Abul Alfia. You know,
yeah, somebody that's crazy.
Even nobody who is. All right, so Rabbi Ginsburg, if he said that, now, it is written that Chizkiyahu, how he was healed with Dveletenim, with the fig tree. And their opinion that he's Emmanuel. Who is Emmanuel for the Christian? He referred to
Yeshua.
Who? Of course. Emmanuel. Who was his father? Who is the father of Emmanuel? Achaz. Who received this prophecy about the birth of Emmanuel? Achaz, right? It will be a miracle that one of your wives, that she's probably very young, she will get pregnant, even she's not too young to become pregnant. You can say that because she's too young, you can say that she's virgin. This can be interpreted. Two ways are perfect. It depends
right,
in what concept of the form.
Young
right, so it's Alma. How many times we have Alma in the Torah?
Three.
Two time.
Oh.
How much equals two time, Alma? Miriam.
Where do we have it? We have
Miriam.
By Miriam.
Alma time to Miriam.
Like
two time, it is written. Two time
Alma
is equal Miriam.
And Alma equals Miriam.
Yes. And in the Bible, it is written two time Alma
if
two.
It's
Rivka, v'etzel Miriam.
Right.
Shel Miriam, achot shel Moshe.
Nachon.
Right, sister of Moses. All right.
Yeah.
All right. So in the Bible we have two time Alma two, in the other books of the Bible two. So we have four time Alma in
three.
All the Bible. So together equal.
Guess,
together numbers. Equal 10 time Chen. Chen always refer to the ark, to the female, to the woman. They give birth to Mashiach, the mother of Mashiach. Chen. Chen, Eshet Chen. Alright, so. Yalat Chen. Hayelet Avim veYalat Chen.
Alright, building off of this, because I know you have the answer, but explain. Okay, so why would, for example, Achaz be given this prophecy, and why would it in Christianity manifest as this concept?
First of all, what generation is Achaz from Avram? Yudke Vavke.
26.
Okay. So he represents the father of Mashiach, the bad guy. The bad guy always represents the father. The bread is a bad guy, right? This is my body.
Bread.
The bread.
The body.
Oh, the bread is the body.
The body is a bad guy.
I think the body is... I don't agree that the body is a bad guy, but I hear you.
The body is Esav. He's the firstborn. Who represents the body is Cain, is Esav, always. Who represents the soul? The Mishneh, the Neshama. What is Mishneh in Hebrew? Mishneh means the second to the king. Mishneh is the second letter of Neshama. Yosef refers to the Neshama. So Yosef is Mishneh Lamelech. Is a child Menashe, is a firstborn. So Yosef gives the birthright to the wrong guy. He did a mistake because he received from Yaakov that the Neshama is most important.
Mm.
But he was wrong. But Yaakov...
That's why Yaakov was...
Now, when Yaakov is oldest, he know better of what he knew when he was young. Mm. He said, no, Ephraim, the body...
Ephraim is the body and Menashe is the Neshama.
Of course, the same letter, Neshama Menashe.
Yeah, right.
Ephraim is the firstborn. He is strongest. He will be more. He will be biggest. All right? So... Mishneh Neshama is second to the king. The king is a body. The king represents the body. David is a king. He's a fighter. He's a sinner. Right? Yosef is a spiritual. He dream. He has vision. Yeshua equal tree of Yosef. Right, it is written that in the future we'll take the tree of Yosef and the tree of Yudah. Et Yosef, Yosef equaling him Et Yeshu, 316. Od Yosef Bni Chai.
316?
316, Yeshu, like we saw before, Arum, naked. Od Yosef Bni Chai, still my son Yosef is alive, equals the same thing, 316. All right, so of course, Jesus refers to the soul. It's why the Jewish didn't receive him.
In what?
It's exactly why the Jewish didn't receive Jesus, because they adapt, because Yaakov is spiritual, he is too spiritual, he adapts Mashiach that is physical. So all the rectification of Judaism is to do, to say the prayer with your mouth, to do action, to do mitzvot, to fight.
Right, because Christianity is just what you believe.
Say bad thing about Chizkiyahu is that instead of going to fight, he go to sleep. He go to sleep, you know, and God will fight for him. He's Mashar ben Yosef. Concept, spiritually, is not somebody that do thing. He just pray to God, you take care, I go to sleep. Right. All right, so... What was his healing?
So could you say
he was healed with the fig tree.
You
remind Chizkiyahu. What?
They wrote it a pasuk. I remember they wrote it a pasuk.
It's a pasuk.
No, I didn't speak Tanakh. Yishchan Nach. I remember they wrote it a pasuk. It's Zayah al Yedei Devela. If Afshar, Vakasha. Yes, he's called me pasuk.
Dvelet Teanim.
What?
Dvelet Teanim.
Dvelet Teanim. Yeah. We're learning Hilchot Shemitah now in Yeshiva, and so we're dealing a lot with Te'inim and a lot with Eitz.
Okay.
Te'inim.
Te'inim.
Yeah.
In the New Testament, they are very important. Mention
also by
of
Adam.
Te'ina.
As of New Testament in Bereishis, it's Veich Guru. Veich Guru.
Yeah.
Okay. Ale Te'inim.
So what we learn from this, the Te'ina. First of all, Tena, the basic opinion is that the Tena is the tree of knowledge, good and evil. It's so the same thing that...
Well, there's a few days in the Gemara. There's a few days
right?
in the Gemara.
Okay.
One of them is that it's Tena tree.
But...
Okay, so...
How do we... Well, they say that the fig leaves.
Right.
Right?
Yeah. So there's one opinion in the Gemara that says that it was figs that he
but,
ate. Another says grapes, another says wheat.
Why this opinion? Why this opinion is more strong of other opinion? Because in the Torah, we have the Tena in this story. Alright? So we have a good reason to think that that is a fig tree. Now let's see what Jesus said about the fig tree. Let's see what he said. First of all, first story about fig tree in the New Testament. If he's angry, he wants to eat tena, he wants to eat fig, and it's the season. And he arrives to a tree of tena, and the fruit no, are not ready yet. So he curses the fig tree. He curses him. He says to the fig tree, Yimach Shimcha, you will not have fruit forever.
Jesus said that?
Yeah. He didn't say Yimach Shimcha, but this is the meaning of what he said. You will not have fruit. It means you are going to die.
So they're all figs?
He said that to these trees died.
Right, in so the moment it's, he it's, said a, so. It's obviously a parable.
Of course.
It's
now. In the chapter in the book of Matthew.
When?
Matthew's in no. Hebrew is Matthew. Is when?
When?
Yeah.
It's a book of time. A 28th chapter parallel to the 28th time of the book of Kohelet. Very deep.
That is pretty deep.
And it's not only, it's parallel to the 28th generation from David to Jesus, the way they are written in the New Testament. It skipped to 5 generations. It's mechuvan.
It skips?
It skipped by purpose. It is a secret, the why it skipped. There are 41 generations exactly from Abraham to Jesus. When we talk about Mashiach, about the DNA of Mashiach, the secret is 41. Eliyahu Mashiach, acronym of M. Moshe Aaron, acronym of M. Mordechai Esther, acronym of M. Eldad Medad, acronym of M, etc. Right? I can continue about the name of Mashiach today, but I'm not. Right? So, M, how much you call Mashiach plus Eliyahu? 410. 10 times 41. All right? So, they start with Avram. How much equal Avram in order number? 41. Right. You start from 41. You know that in mathematics, you have a series of prime numbers that start with 41, of 40 prime numbers, and the last one, the 41, is 41 squared. It's not anymore a prime number, but it's the last one in this series.
You're saying 41 squared is a prime number? Sorry, I don't get it.
No, 41 is a prime number.
41 is a prime number, right? Yeah.
This refers to Avraham.
Okay.
So you can parallel all the 41 generation to this 41 prime number. Avraham, how you said it? First of all, you have two, a triangle of zero, it's zero, right? Two prime number of zero. Plus 41. This is the first one. After you have two prime number of one.
What is the triangle?
Triangle is 1 + 2 + 3 + 4, like we did with Yud. Triangle of 4 is 10. So after we have two triangle of one, plus 41, this is the second. This equal.
Why don't you?
This equal 43. 1 plus 1 plus 41 equal 43.
What's the difference? Why
after you have two triangle of 2 equal 47. How much equal Yaakov? This is generation. How much equal Yaakov in a order number? 47.
I have a question. Why did you put this one, like,
this will be always prime number. If you do a series like this,
triangle from 1 and to 40, triangle,
from
difference?
0 to 40, two triangle plus 41.
Are you adding these two together? You're adding this?
Yes, this plus this plus 41.
Do you not make a cross on purpose, even though you're like a huge Jesus fan?
Now, after this plus 41.
See the question?
After two.
No, it's like a Jewish thing. Like, they don't want to make a
after
cross.
After 2.
I think so.
After 2 plus
47.
41.
I don't know.
This equal, how much equal? This is 1 plus 2 equal 3. This is 6 plus 41 is 47. This Yaakov equal 47 in Mishpar Siduri.
Right.
Etc.
Etc. And you always get
refer to all the generation it talk about. Wow. It's very deep.
It's Kabbalah, book.
Yeah.
You know this?
I did not know that.
A Christian teach you about this? No, Christian teach you about this. He even doesn't know Hebrew.
Yeah, exactly. This is like super crazy, bro. But like, this is not like anything like I've...
Okay.
Kamachis.
All right, so this 28th chapter refer to the 28th letter with the Mantzapach and with the Aleph that become Aleph. Two. And the 28th chapter refer to the 28th king from David to Jesus too, I said it. All right, so it's a very deep book. In the chapter 24, it's time to talk. It's time to talk. Before this is time, we cannot talk. We cannot talk about Jesus. So they ask him in chapter 24, when will be the second coming? When you came again? When you come back? When will be the second coming of Mashiach? What he say? He say parable, what people say about the fig tree, that when the fig tree start to be ready, the fruit start to be ready, it means that the summer is close. Kaitz. It's a pasuk. And kaitz is like cats. We can learn from a nevuah about a kluv kaitz. It's after he talk about the cats, the end of the day. So it make a connection. He talk in Hebrew. So I make a connection between the kite and the cats. So the end of the day will be when the fig tree will be ready. Now, what he talk, when he say fig tree, what he talk about? He talk about the tree of knowledge, good and evil. He talk about the Torah. Now, he didn't eat the fig tree. It's why he's naked. And if he's naked, if he didn't learn Torah, He cannot fix this world. If you didn't eat the tree of knowledge, good and evil, you cannot fix the snake. The snake is a physical reality. Now, in the New Testament, it's another story about the fig tree. From this, we'll know exactly what he means when he says fig tree.
Right, everyone will sit under their fig tree?
Philip, no.
No, Torah.
He's going.
Yochanan, from Yochanan, right? With Natanel. I saw you under the fig tree.
Yes, okay. So he's going to meet Natanel, his sixth disciple. He has 12 disciples that all it to the 12th tribe. Right? Now, in many ways, like Yaakov. Vayikra Shmo Yaakov, what is acronym?
Vayikra
Shmo Yaakov.
Yeshu,
you see. Viado Chesed Ba'akev Esa, Vayikra Shmo Yaakov, Yeshua. Vayikra Shmo Esav, acronym of Esav. But I don't know that Esav is Esav, what is what you teach me? But if Esav is Esav, Yaakov is Yeshu the same way. So, he's going to meet Natanael, his sixth disciple, and when he see him coming from far away, he say, well, this guy is a real son of Israel that don't know what is a lie. He's a person of truth. And so Natanael asks Jesus, how you know me? So Jesus tell him, I saw you before, I know you from before, from the past, when you was under the fig tree.
Because he said to who?
Jesus said to Natanael. Before Natanael met Jesus, he was talking with Philip,
disciple.
Of Jesus, and Philip tells to Natanael, you must meet this guy. I met somebody, why? Maybe he's Mashiach. You must meet him, right? So he tells, and there was under the fig tree. But Jesus, he tell, I know you of the time, from the ancient time, this is what he meant, when you was under the fig tree. Who was under the fig tree?
The snake.
The snake. Who was under the tree of knowledge, good and evil? The snake. Still, you are a person of truth. Now I know why he said it, that you are not a liar, because everybody knows that the snake is a liar. Still, you are a person of truth, you are not a liar.
Even though you're under the fig tree.
Even your soul refer to the snake. Now, which tribe is Netanel? He's the sixth one. Let's check. The first one is Shimon Kepha. Shimon. There are two orders of the...
Of the apostles? 12th.
Of the 12th... Of the tribes, of Yaakov. There are two orders. It's the order of birth, and it's the order of the flag, the way they used to walk in the desert. Two main orders.
Right.
Let's take the order of birth. In the order of birth, Shimon is the second one, right? After Reuven, Shimon. Levi, Yehuda, Yisachar, Zvulun. We put always Yisachar and Zvulun together. All the children of Leah together, the way that they put the stone. This is the order of the stone.
Okay.
They put Yisachar. Alright, so you have Shimon, Levi, Yehuda, Yisachar, Zvulun, Dan. It's the sixth one. Six is always referred to the beast. 666, right?
What do you mean by the beast? What do you mean by the beast? I don't
the number of the beast in the book of Revelation in the New Testament is 666.
That's the number of the beast. It says that explicitly in
the New
Testament?
Yes, it's the number of the beast. It's why they put this number, 666. All the it's why Bill Gates make a patent on his ID 2020.
I saw. What does the number of the beast? Which beast? I want the pasuk in the thing. What do they mean when they say of the beast?
I tell you.
Yeah, I know. Do you have the New Testament? We can see. I want to see. Like, what do they mean by the beast? Yeah.
1 second. He said a vision about the end of the day. This is a book of Revelation. He said what will happen in the end of the day. All right. So he says there are four riders. This is the first one. I asked somebody to do this before I even knew that it is a book that called Book of Revelation. I didn't read it when I start to write this book. Wow. I just write a book about Mashiach based on the word Chan, and all the Christianity just appears there. I didn't search for it. I wrote an introduction to my book. My book is based on three concepts. Mashiach, the hero of the story. Mashiach, the goal of the story. Chen, the key of Yitzchak to receive the story. And then after I realized it had the acronym of Yimach. Okay? I tell you a true story. I didn't learn it from the New Testament. I learned it from the Torah.
Okay,
so now we talk about the 666. He says that the number of the beast is 666.
Okay.
Why 666?
Tough race, sad love.
Why not 555? Why not 777? What not? I don't know what. Right? There are two basic numbers interesting in the New Testament, and they are both very, very deep numbers. Is 153 fishes, big fishes. Right?
153?
Big fishes.
But this is also interesting.
Wow, what interesting thing you have with this number. Wow.
What?
What interesting thing you have with this number, 153.
Really?
Yeah. I'm going to give now the third video just about this number, 153. Now I give a series about 153.
Cool, what? A series.
So it's very deep. 666, what is 666?
Tough race, Samech
Vav. They believe in what? They believe the Illuminati, the beast, believe that the snake, that Lucifer is a good guy, is a light. He give us the science, he give us the Torah, right? The snake give us the tree of knowledge, good and evil. He's a good guy, he's a light. And the God of, and the bad, the, all the
Hevel, religion that came from the family of Shet, of Hevel, is a bad guy, it's a darkness, all the monotheism religion is a bad guy. We believe in Lucifer, the light, the snake. They believe in the snake.
Who says this?
What is the mystical foundation of this? You know, the Illuminati, they continue the belief of this ancient Rome before Christianity. The Wadjes is a continuation of the religion of Rome that came from Greece, that came from old Egypt. They believe in Osiris. Set, kill Osiris. Set is Shet. Is a Jewish. Is a.
Shaped is Osiris?
Set kill Osiris. They believe in the god Osiris, the good guy. He's a snake. He's a good snake, Osiris. What is the obelisk? Is the ever mean of Osiris. Obelisk, really? You have everywhere. Yeah. Is the ever mean of Osiris. But he lost it. Kelach Heristeris. The other god, like we said in Kabbalah, is the god of... the other god, the Elohim Acherim, is Saris. He don't have a real production. They said by themselves that he's Saris. He lost it because Set. He lost it because Set. Right, he part his body to 14 part, and Isis, his wife's sister,
right.
Find 13 other part, bring him back to life, but the 14... part, what is the ever mean of Osiris? He was eating by three fish. There are many secrets with these three fish and the name of the fish. They even give you the name. This is a religion of the Freemason, of the Illuminati. Right?
Right, but I'm saying, do we know where that's written? Like, Efo Zekatuv, is this like written? Like,
you can, there are.
Why knew that already from studying Egyptian history about Seth Kendall?
So, where is that?
You can learn about the mythology of Egypt.
Right.
And you can learn the mythology of the Freemasons, that maybe they change it. They make a big salad with Babylon, with Greece, with Rome, with. They make a big salad all together, and they have a religion. It's a religion. That's why, and they want to destroy all the other religion, and all the other nation, and all the other people. They don't want them anymore. Only few, like slaves. This is what they want to do.
Yeah.
They're free enemy. Religion, a state, and people. Amim.
Mm-hmm.
Refer to the free fishes, of course. Refer to the free people that kill Hiram. Hiram the builder.
Hiram, yeah.
There are free Freemasons that kill Hiram. Why free?
Yeah, Hiram okay.
Now, what is the secret of 666? Let's see if it is any something deep in this number. Let's write Nachash. I write it in symmetry because all the devil stuff have to do with symmetry.
All the what?
All the Satanism really think just... like to do think backwards, opposite, like Purim. They like to do everything backwards. We have this in holiness, we have snake in holiness, and we have 666 in holiness, and we have 666 not in holiness. We have a good snake and we have a bad snake. The snake, the chen is nachash. Sheker achen is nachash. Nutrikon sheker achen. Belong to Noach, to all the people, all the nation. After Am Yisrael do a separation. Avram, Yofi, Andred, Hevel. Yitzchak, he was Hevel, he was 37 when he was sacrificed. Right, so now we're talking about... And Avram was 100 years old when he gave him birth. Yeah. Alright, so now we took the Hevel Ayofi, we separate the two from all the nation, from the Chen and the Sheker. Now the Mashiach, he come back to all the nation. He come back to Chen. Because all the power of infinite are in the lie. The lie is more deep of the truth. It's the root of the truth.
איך זה נקרא שאתה עושה את זה?
You call it Nachash Bechen Elyon.
Bechen Elyon?
It's Chen is symmetry in Hebrew. It's a beauty.
Wow. Chen is symmetry in Hebrew.
Yeah, this is a beauty of symmetry. There are eight kinds of beauty according to, parallel to the eight candles of Hanukkah.
Right.
Shefer,
Chanukah.
Yofi,
Chanukah.
Tov, Tovat Mar'e, Tov, Pe'er, Tiferet, Noi, Semletor of Yavan,
yeah.
Hod,
So this is called symmetry. What's called what?
Hadar. Chen, yeah. Hadar is Yosef, is the sphere of Yesod, and Chen is Malchut. Right? Chen refers to symmetry, like Noach Matzah Chen. Shnaim Baru El Noach El Atava. Always two, always balance. Shnaim equal eight times Nun. And in order number, Shnaim equal Chen. So you see that Chen always refers to two opposite. Always two opposite to the Ark of Noach. Always two opposite. The principle of the Ark of Noach, if you have Yaakov, you must have Esav. If you think if you have the tree of knowledge, good and evil, must to be there, the tree of knowledge, good and evil. Not the tree of only the tree of knowledge, good.
Well, even like
Chaim Vital said. It's wrong. In the garden of God is the tree of knowledge, good and evil. You are not going to take the evil out, or the kitzutz banetiot. We need both of them. Shnaim, always two.
That's pshat and kitzutz banetiot.
Now, how much equal nachash if you write it in this symmetry?
666.
Now, let's reverse the symmetry. We write now nachash like this. How much equal?
416.
What is? Lucifer. Okay? This is a 666, this is a beast.
Lucifer. Lucifer. Efo zekatuv ba Torah?
No, Lucifer is not
in Torah. Efo zekatuv?
Lucifer.
What's the makor? איפה המקור של המילה? של הרעיון? מה המקור של הרעיון של לוציפר?
This is the way the goyim call the devil. There are many things that are in the goyim. Holy spark. Holy spark.
Holy ba'er and havut yair.
Those are neither in Chazal.
When I say Chazal, I mean.
No, it has to be medayek, bro.
I thought of my school thought the other day.
Yeah, but when you say Chazal, that's like Chazal. That
we call him Armelus. Or we call him the Samech Mem.
Armelus, I've heard of. Armelus, I saw.
Armelus.
I saw recently Armelus.
What you have in Armelus?
I saw Armelus in
the what Gemara. Letter you have in Armelus?
No, we saw Armelus with the arrow.
Wait,
let's skip letter.
If that's not Chazal, what are you saying?
Let's take the name Armelus. What is it? Tsar Mashiach. What four letters you have here when you skip every time a letter? You skip the Riyu. What you receive the letter of? The Samech Mem. Samech Mem Aleph Lamed.
Right.
Samech El.
Right.
Samech Mem El. Right?
Yeah, I know.
Alright. And what is the Riyu?
It's Shem Hashem in Olam HaBriah.
What is the Riyu? It's holy name in Kabbalah.
Yeah, I know. It's Shem Hashem in
Olam HaBriah. That is six times six. 666.
It's 216.
What is 36 times 6? Cube of 6.
6 cubed?
Yes.
I don't know.
666.
666.
This number can be very interesting.
No, very interesting. I never seen Torah like I never come across this stuff. You know, I don't know. Like this is like very interesting. I know that's like what the deep Kabbalists. Like,
okay, so now we come back to Netanel 6. He's a sixth one. We say that you know in the order of birth is the sixth after Shimon. Now let's check the other order of the flag. Now, Shimon is the fifth one. parallel to the month of Av, is Shimon. After Shimon is Gad. After Ephraim, after Menashe, after Binyamin, after Dan in the month of Tevet, the cold month. And the letter Ein. Ein is the letter of the snake according to Sefer Yetzirah.
Okay.
It's the letter of Dan. Dan Nachash.
Dan Nachash.
Shifon. Right, so Jesus lost the letter Ein in the first coming. We call him Yeshu, not Yeshua. Because the letter Ein refers to the fig tree, to the snake. But he's naked. It means he don't have the Ein. He don't have the clothing. Seven always refer to clothing. It's like he's one and he's 70 around. It's a surround clothing. It's like the Shivim Panim La Torah. The Torah and the Shivim face around. It's like seven perspective. How to see the light? You have six side, four side, up and down in the middle.
Right.
Each one of them contain 10 spheres. They become seven. It's like the seven midot. Right? When you before Matan Torah, we do Chesed Shebe Chesed, Vura Shebe Chesed, Tiferet. We do a rectification of the midot, so we do it Kalelut of all the attributes of the art. Until we get to 50, after we do a seven square. We count seven square day, right?
Yeah.
So this seven always refer to something that it's like a closing. So Jesus, when the first man go to eat the fig tree, the Yechida, it is written in Kabbalah, didn't participate. It's why the first man fall apart. Because the Yechida put everything together.
Right.
We have another story about the Yechida. The only place in the whole Bible we have the word Yechida, not Yachid. Yechida reading. It's about the daughter of Yiftach.
Right.
It is written that she is Yechida daughter.
Great Zag.
And
oh, saying that she's his only daughter.
Now he sacrificed her. What happened to Yiftach? That they buried him in the Arei Gilad. In the many places he was buried.
Arei Gilad?
He was not buried in one place. So it is written in Kitvei Arizal that as a punishment for what he did.
Where is the Arei Gilad?
His body fall apart.
Where is the Arei Gilad? I know the Arei Gilboa.
No, the Gilad is referred to the Reuven in the Ever Hayarden, the Golan.
Gilad, no, Gilad was when Yaakov and Lavan.
Yeah, it's referred to the.
And Yaakov and Lavan, it says, right? He calls it something the.
Galed.
And he says, and Yaakov called it Galed.
All right, so this is the way he calls the stone, Galed.
Right.
Somewhere between Aram, between Mesopotamia,
mm-hmm.
where was Lavan, and between Eretz Israel. They put a stone there, right? All right, so Jesus said, if I am naked, if the fruit is not ready, you have to curse me. You have to curse me. But when will be the second coming?
When the curse itself becomes a blessing.
It means the fig tree is ready. What it means is ready. It's connected to the tree of life. The Torah is ready. How we call it in Hasidut? Orot de tohu bekelim de tikkun. Admor HaZaken wrote in Parashat Vayishlach that Esav mit Yaakov that this is a redemption. That the meat, the kiss, and what Esav represent? Esav represent light of chaos. Yaakov represent kelim de tikkun. What is Christianity? Hallelujah! Just light. Where is the vessel? Where is the Torah?
Where is the kelim? Where is the
maisis?
Nesht.
But they are in euphoria, they are in trance. Right? Christian, when they pray, they pray.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, they know how to pray. We don't know how to pray. We forget long time ago how to pray. Okay. You know, we do, blah, 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 blah. We have a routine to say it. They pray. They really pray to their Lord, whoever he is. Right? So, it's light. They've light. There's the light of Mashiach, but it's a naked truth. And Jesus said, and the Torah said, Ki tirah rum v'chisito. If you see a naked one, you cannot talk about him. Because what you are going to say about Jesus? Give the second cheeks? You even don't understand what it means, the light of the face in Kabbalah. Yeah. What it means. There are many secrets in this, but what you understand that, you know, don't fight, don't do nothing, you know. It's like this world it not exists. They kill you, no, it doesn't matter if they kill you because you have Olam Haba. We have to give the tax to the Caesar. All right, let's say you are Mashiach. So what you are going to do about the problem? We have Rome here, we have a big problem. You are going to fight with them? No, I cannot. I'm sorry. I didn't have the victory. I cannot be Mashiach ben David. I cannot realize my function. It's why he was very upset when the victory was not ready. Give it to the Caesar, what belongs to the Caesar, we make a separation. Asa will take care of, you know, of politics. Mm-hmm. Trump will take care of politics. And the Afifa will take care of God, of the religion. Right? He make a separation. He cannot do better. Cannot do better. But ask him, what about the second coming when the fig tree will be ready? It means I will not be anymore naked. And he said this in the chapter Et Ledaber. Now we can talk. If it is a naked tree, I cannot talk about Jesus. What I will say? That he teaches me to be a good person. It's not enough. But if we learn it deeply, why did the miracle of the one in a place called Cana? What I care? Why Philip is under a fig tree? And if it was a tree of 400, what I care? If it's not if we don't learn it, we've connected to the tree of life, to the Kabbalah, to the Hasidut. What I care? Just a story. And it just teach me to be a good person. But when I go deep, I try to check number, I try to check he refers to time. Why you have 28 chapters? And why in the chapter, we talk now about the 153 fish, the chapter 17, Tov. They have to pay their machatzit shekel. So, Petros asked, what we are going to do? We don't have money. So go to, you know, Petros, he was a fishman. So go to fish. The first fish you catch, you open his mouth, you will find the shkalim we need. All right, so chapter 17 is the time, Levakesh. What generation is this after David? Shaltiel, Levakesh, Shaltiel.
Shaltiel was the father of Zerubbabel. Yeah.
Exactly.
Shaltiel equal to a lot after David. Yeah, there was a lot after David. It wasn't the next generation.
In the book, it's a generation for 17 after David in 17 Tov generation. Like it's a Tov time 17 time is a time to us. Levakesh is Bet Shkalim, Bet Shekel. Right? There are many secrets why we ask Bet Shkalim. What refers the Bet Shkalim? He refers to two times $2 million. Four blood. There are four machatzit shekels that we need to bring Mashiach.
Four machatzit shekels?
It's another concept.
I want to hear a lot about all this.
In the end of the story,
we may have to part two.
Is there a story about, you know, when after Jesus come back from death, they are going to catch 150 big fish. All right, so What is connected to the fish we saw before?
No, we're talking about fish before that they.
What the 153 have to do with Tov 17 generation? If you do a triangle of 17, 1 plus 2 plus 3 until 17,
yeah, then you get 153.
All right, you see. Mm. Not only this, 153 is
3 times 51. And there is gematria junk.
It means it's the same number. And 51 equals 3 times Tov. And 153 equal 9 times 4. And if you do 1 plus 3 plus 5 equal 9. So if you split 153 to 9 equal 12. And if you do 153 equal 153. If you write now, Hamishim Veshalosh as a number. Now, where in the Torah, where is the first mem in the Torah? It's another kind of gematria.
The first name?
The first letter mem in the Torah.
Oh, the first letter mem of the Torah? Mayim?
Is from Elohim. It's the 14. It's the 14.
Yes.
It's the 14. The first name is 14.
Shemaim.
Aleph is Shemaim. A three letter. Bereshit. Hey is a 12th letter.
Bara.
Hey. Chet. Chet is a 46th letter. The first appearance. Mem. Mem is a 14. Shin is a 4 letter.
Right.
Yud is a 5th letter.
Mem is the 14.
Mem is again 14. Vav is a 22 letter. Shin is a 4 letter. Lamed is a 11 letter. Shin again 4. How much you call all together?
I don't know.
153.
I could guess that though. Yeah, here, wow, yeah. Unbelievable.
All right, exactly.
And you figure out all this by yourself?
Yes.
So what do? You just like sit and like do math and then like you're like, oh, this is a match, now I can like say I'm in Torah?
I do research. I do mechkar.
Mechkar.
Mechkar. It's like science. I do research.
You're like you said, you're a
my rabbi, he learned, my rabbi learned all what people said. Everybody says. So in all the Torah by heart. All the Talmud.
Yitzhak Ginsburg.
Yeah. Rabbi Melubavitch as well. They know everything by heart. And I get best of learning. Vessel. How to learn. Vessel of Kabbalah from my rabbi.
Right.
But I do research. All day.
Yeah, we also. Yeah.
I do for 40 years research. About wow. Mashiach.
Amazing.
What is Mashiach? Who is Mashiach? Who is Mashiach ben David? Who is Mashiach ben Yosef? Who is the donkey? Who is the bull? Etc. All right?
It's
so I do research. So it's all a book about Mashiach.
It's
all
amazing. It's really amazing, bro.
We may have to part two it, Rabbi.
Yeah, because, part two it.
We got Shir tomorrow in Yeshiva.
Yeah, we got Shir. Okay.
So the idea that in the moment, we have vessel of Torah to talk about Jesus. I can't talk about any rabbi about Jesus. He will not smash my face.
You can talk to me about it. I'm Richo, listen,
but if a Messianic came to somebody in Mashar,
like Michael Brown. Messianic. Like Michael Brown.
He will
like
come, he just will say the word Jesus, they will punch his face. Right?
Yeah,
and I live here in Masharim. People ask me what I do. Well, I do rectification of Christianity. I talk with anybody you want about Jesus. No problem. In the shul where I pray, I can't talk about Jesus.
Okay,
no problem.
And Masharim equals 666.
Yeah,
Masharim is 666. Mordek.
Vayar bashanai Masharim. All this verse equals 3 times 666, all the verse.
Wow.
That you have Me'asharim in it.
They say by Yeshua, the Gemara, that he was Mahapech the Levana,
the Levin,
the one who said it's not part of the story. It's like aricha, editing. They have idea that Christianity took one stone from all the building. The building have many stones. It's not only love. We have fear. We have tiferet. We have in our morality. We have many concepts in the name. It's not only love. But they try to say that Christianity take only one stone.
Nice.
And they make from it avodah zarah.
Right. In lobati el lishma adavar zeh, dayenu. You gave me pshat in the Gemara. I love it. Also the other Gemara stuff. I'm going to think about it.
How much equal Yeshua ben Prachya and Gemetia?
No idea.
Natsrut, Christianity.
Nice.
746.
Yeshua ben Prachya.
He made the Christianity. He's Hashem of we have Christianity.
Yeah, right. Yeshua ben Prachya was a shmark.
Alright.
Yeah, we're gonna hit the road. Right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. This was wonderful. Thank you so much. It was great meeting you and getting to hear all of your Torah knowledge.